Hello Facebook, Steve Woody here from Online Mastery, and today is episode number 20. I can't believe it's been like 4 weeks now that we've been doing this. I'm just going to really quickly flip the screen around because obviously I want you to see what I'm writing, so that should hopefully help. And today we're going to do something a little bit different. So I'm going to tell you now that I do not know how this is going to go. And the reason I don't know how this is going to go is because obviously not only am I doing it live, but I'm about to make a live phone call. So this morning I checked Facebook and I went through, as I do most mornings, and I was looking at what was happening. And I spoke to a friend of mine, said that she needed help in her business. And so I said, love to help you. This is, you know, what you need to do. Unfortunately, I'm not working with any clients now until May. And turns out, because I know I've been watching her for a while, she's got as a business, it's quite successful. She's a local printer and she's up in Birmingham in the UK. So she does printing for like flyers, leaflets, banners, t-shirts and things like that. But she's struggling a little bit. So I wanted to, literally, I said, look, I can't work with you one-on-one at the moment because I've got no space. But if we can create a win-win situation where you come on the live, I will talk you through what it is you need and we'll do a live session, like a live coaching session, hopefully give her something to go away with in her business to get real results, and we can check that. And you guys can obviously take this away as well. Sound good? Give me some likes, thumbs up, some hearts, give me some hellos. Let me just know, because otherwise, you know, I don't want to do this if it's not worth it. We can always go back to talking about sales funnels. I just thought this would be different. And this is another reason why it's important to be agile, to be flexible so that you can kind of change things and do things, because this could be really good. This could be the start of something. Let's see. So I've got Skype on my computer and I am literally about to call. So anything right now could happen at this point. I'm well aware of that. Amy? Let's hope she answers. Skype, right? The internet was a little bit dodgy this morning as well. I feel like a radio show. Hi, you're through it. No, it doesn't work like that, does it? Right. See if this works. She might be with a customer.
Hello?
Hello, Amy?
Hello?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yeah,
can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Can you hear me?
I can. You're live on Facebook. Hi. I feel like a radio show host.
Are you okay?
I'm good. Are you? You well?
Yes, thank you.
Awesome. So, what we're going to do, I've got you on the call. I've got the Facebook Live going, and I know I spoke to you briefly earlier. The first thing I want to say is don't be nervous. Don't worry about this. I'm not going to do anything bad at all. I'm just going to give you something that you can use in your business, because we had a brief talk about, what was it, an hour or so ago. And I was wondering if you could just for a minute just explain to everyone who's watching what it is that you do. Like, what's the name of your company? What does your company do? Where's it based? Who are you? What do you do?
Okay, so my name's Amy Fitz. I run a print company called Print People.
So the company's called Printing People.
Yeah, Print People.
Print People, and it's in Birmingham. Excellent. So, all right. Yeah. When I spoke to you earlier, you said that you wanted to get more sales into the business, right?
Yeah.
And so you had a website, didn't you? At first, you had like an e-commerce website that had like people could order online.
Yeah, we did, yeah. We had that, and then we had the previous person that designed it for me, there was orders being mad, but I didn't know where that was going when he left the business, so I've got someone working on it at the minute, and I want to change it to a simple one.
Okay, so what you've done is you've taken the store, which was an e-commerce store, and you're now making it so that it's a more simplified version for you.
Yeah, just more simple, so just got the basics on there, so you just see some of the special offers we do. I'd rather customers contact me directly rather than an online buying thing, so you can build a relationship with them as well.
Okay, so let's start with, and it's really good. Guys, sorry if you can't hear the audio, I'll do my best to sort of push this across so you can hear it. The thing that I want to know right now, and you don't need to tell me the numbers, obviously I appreciate you don't have to tell me that, but what, in your head, what do you need to take out a company a month in wages? And also, is there any other staff that you've got that work with you? Just you. Right,
I'm
so...
I'm with his partner, but he doesn't have much involved.
Okay, so in that case, what do you and your business partner need to take out the company as wages? Don't tell me, but just bear that in your mind. And then you've actually got a physical shop as well, haven't you?
Yeah.
Right, so there's going to be running costs, yeah?
Yeah.
And then there's going to be, obviously, you've got your running costs for the business itself, there's the product costs and things as well. So you've got the running costs, then you've got the material costs and things like that. There's like obviously other bills and things like that. So if you understand those numbers as well, I just want you to sort of consider, just for a moment, what you need to earn in terms of a wage on a monthly basis, what your business partner needs to earn in terms of a wage on a monthly basis, what the running costs, the product costs and everything are within your business, and that should give you a number. And whatever that number is, that is what you need to earn per month gross, yeah?
Yeah.
Do you know what that figure is? You don't have to tell me, but do you know what it is? Roughly.
I don't know it at the minute, no.
No, but you can find it out though, right?
I know roughly how much it costs a day to run.
Okay. Yeah, that's good.
So I can probably work it out.
Yeah, so we can work it out, because what I really want to do at the moment is if we can work out what it costs to run your business in terms of the running costs, the overheads, the wages, everything else, then the first thing to know is obviously what that number is, and then we can look at what your income is, and are you either, you know, falling short, meeting or exceeding that number? Because you've already said that you want to obviously increase sales, and I get that, but if we have an actual benchmark, like something to work with, like where you are now and where you want to be, then that's going to make it really easy to say, okay, this is working or this isn't working. Do you know what I mean? Because, like, here's the thing. I could build you a website, or you could go to anyone to build you a website. But the reality is, if you don't have this plan in place, like, if you don't have this strategy as to why you're building it, like, we need to have an actual outcome. So we need to say, like, what the outcome is, you want to generate an extra £5,000 a week in sales, for example. And so now we need to look at, okay, so what are the numbers? What does that take? And so once you've got that, and you can watch the live, we'll go back through this. I'm actually writing it on a whiteboard. So if you're on the Facebook Live, you'll see this as well.
Yeah.
But the next thing I want to know is, you've obviously got products and services that you sell, right?
Yeah.
What are your, at the moment, like, I know that you forwarded me a leaflet. I'm just having a quick look at that now, because you pinged me over a flyer. Of like a price list that you've got, and like, I can see you do like posters, flyos, you do like combinations, you even do design for the work. So what would you say at the moment, given that you're an established business, what are your best sellers at the moment? What are the things that people really want from you?
We sell a lot of business cards, flyers, and business stationery, like Left Heads compliment clips. We started, since we got a new machine, we started doing more banners as well, roller banners and canvases.
Okay, so you're doing more banners, roller banners and things like that. So stationery, so like, are you saying for like events? Do you do stuff for event people?
We do a few bits for event people. That's just purely our Facebook advertisement, nothing walking trade.
Okay, so walk-in trade could be anything really, I suppose. Is there anything that you want to focus on? Is there anything specifically that for the business is like the thing you're like, actually, do you know what, we want to focus in this direction, this is what we want to look at?
I mean, at the minute, there's not much I want to focus on selling as much, because we do such a variety of stuff. I just know the more things we do is business cards and flyers more than anything.
Right, so, all right, so let's look at that then. So, business cards and flyers. Just promotional stuff, yeah?
Yeah.
So you do stationery, you do promotional things as well. And in terms of sort of the average cost per order, what would you say in terms of business cards would be your average cost per order? All right, so £60 for an order there. And in terms of flyers?
Maybe about
107. Okay. And obviously you've got cost there as well, right? So there's things that you need to take into account.
Yeah.
But if we're looking at what you can do and how you can do this. What we can say is, right, so when someone comes in and buys business cards, I'm assuming that you have the ability to upsell them, well, actually, would you like this as well or that? And you can sort of put a package together where you say, actually, we'll give you flyers and some stationery, and you do a package for them.
Okay.
I don't know if you've done that before, if you thought about that.
I think it's more of a confidence thing. I'll just normally take the order and process it. I never try to upsell.
Okay.
Which I should do.
Well, this is a really good idea. So what I would say is, what is your cheapest product that you sell that everybody wants, that is kind of like just the entry level? Like, people normally come to you because they start by needing something.
It's normally they come in and say, I need small figures, and the minimums we do, say business cards, is 100.
So business cards is kind of a good starting point.
But then when they see the cost of 100 compared to the 1,000, they tend to just go for that anyway.
Right, so what you're doing is up.
Which is the 1,000 is the £60. Yeah.
£60 for 1,000 business cards. Great. So guys, look on the Facebook Live, if you need business cards, go speak to Amy and get 1,000 business cards for £60. I'm sure it's a one-time offer today only. She'll design them for you as well. I haven't asked her. But here's the thing, right? So for a business owner or for somebody, because I suppose really you've got to look at who's your target audience. Like, who do you attract? Is it business owners? Is it event people? Is it one-offs? Is it like local people that are just getting started?
Business owners.
Okay, so we're looking.
Yeah, just like start businesses mainly. We've got a lot of people that come back. Yep. Like regular customers that order like every 3 weeks to a month, but it's not massive amounts of orders.
Okay, so right now we've got business owners, they're starting off with business cards and they're spending about £60 on average on their first order for 1,000 business cards.
Yeah.
That's a good starting point, so we're going to use that for now. Obviously there are other things that we can add into this and we can look at, but right now, because what I see you doing, and like, I totally get this because I used to have a printing business myself and we did the exact same thing. We started off with t-shirts and then we did embroidery and then we did like sublime printing and then we did business cards. And I mean, we were really naughty. Well, we're not naughty, but when we did business cards, we used to go to Vistaprint, get the cards printed. We went onto eBay, got some clear plastic boxes, put the Vistaprint cards into clear plastic boxes and shipped them off for like £5. Like, it was a loss leader. Like, we didn't make any money on it. But what it did is it allowed us to get the custom so that people could come back. And then we used to do the t-shirts and we did the websites and we started doing everything else. So, like, we upsell and we ended up with about a £1,000 to £2,000 client off the back of some business cards that literally cost us a fiver.
Oh, my gosh.
Do you see what I'm saying, though, about how you... Like, what we need to look at is two things. One is the traffic that's coming into your business. So how do we attract a list of people? And you're in Birmingham, is that right?
Yeah.
But you're not limited to Birmingham, are you? So you can ship to anywhere in the UK?
Yeah, we can ship anywhere.
Anywhere in the world? Are you global or are you...
I don't charge for shipping. Yeah.
You don't charge for
not
shipping?
Not worldwide, we ship... No. No, we don't charge for shipping. We just put it in with the price.
And you still make a profit?
Yeah.
Okay, because this is a good thing to know, because that is kind of like a USP for you. It's like, look, we don't charge shipping, because pretty much every print company that I know charges shipping.
Yeah.
So this is really good. This is really good, because if you have an agreement or the ability to not charge, I'm not saying you shouldn't, I don't know, but if you're not going to charge, then that should be, look, we're not charging shipping. This fee is what you pay. What you see is what you pay, that's it. It's really simple. Click on this, get this, you're done. Like, 1, 2, because most people, they don't want to mess about. Some people want to have a look. Like, you've got two types of people. You've got the type of people that are like, I need a business card. I know I need a business card. I want a business card. They come to you. What's the price? How much are you going to cost? I want to upload my business cards. I'm done. I want to know I'm going to get it in a few days. Like, there's the people who are just like, I want... Do you know what I mean? And there's the other person that wants to know exactly what tree was cut down to make the paper that you're going to print the card on. So you need to be able to cater for both. You need to be able to give the instant access to the people that want to give you money now. And you also need to be able to give people the ability to learn more if they want to. So I do agree with having a website that's not just an e-commerce store that gives people the ability to learn more about you, about your... Because this is the thing. You want to build a brand. Like, print people should be a brand that everyone in Birmingham knows, and it's like, oh, you need business cards? Like, I know, I've seen this. The whole reason we're talking now is because I've seen on Facebook, when someone says, I need printing, your name pops up 3, 4, 5, 6 times in the comments. But the reason that happens is because people know, like, and trust you, right? And so it's important that you...
Well,
they do. I mean, I know you said about a confidence thing, but, like, people are buying because they like you. They get on with you. They know you. You deliver a service. You deliver a result to them. And so they're happy. They're happy with the quality. They're happy with the process. They're happy with you. So they come back. And not only do they come back, but they refer people, which is kind of like you're getting free advertising off of this because everyone's doing your marketing for you.
Yeah.
And trust me, the strongest type of marketing you can possibly get in your business is referral, word of mouth. Like, it's the best type you can get. Because it's social proof, it's a testimonial, it's everything all in one. And so the best way to do that is to obviously give people that experience. So, like, I'm hoping, I'm going to check the feeds out in a minute, but I think this is really good because what we're looking at here now, and what I really want to focus on, is I think what you've got is great, I think what you're doing is great. I think what would be really, really simple here, I don't think we need to overcomplicate this. Like, I know you're saying you want to grow and offer more services. I actually think the best thing you can do right now is go the other way and actually focus on one core service. Right now, in your local area, to start with, and just say, do you know what? I am going to be the number one business card distributor in Birmingham. But that is my goal. That is what I am going to be. And then you just focus all of your efforts and attempts on getting people in to purchase business cards from you. And then you can build your website in a way that is, it can have the shop and people can browse, but you have a landing page that is geared up specifically for business cards that allows people to say, do you want a business card? This is what you need. This is how you do it. Click, click, click. 1, 2, 3, you're done. A bit like, because you've got competition with Vistaprint, you've got Moo.com, you've got local printers as well.
Yeah.
Like, there's a lot of business out there. So the only way you're going to stand out is with, like you said, that personal touch. And so if you are known as the go-to person for business cards or for flyers, whatever it is, that is going to give you the ability to sort of get in with that new client. Because you've got two things, right? You've got new and you've got repeat business. So what you need to consider is for new business, how are you going to attract this new business? What are you going to do that's different? Like, maybe you're going to have a day where all the design is free. So anyone that wants a design can get it done for free for the day. And you need to pre-book people in. So they need to book like hour slots with you. And they'll get their business card designed for free for the day. Like, I'm not saying that's what you need to do, but something like that. A way that you can market yourself in your local area, because people are more likely, they like buying things locally, so start there first and test this. Because the thing that you need to do more than anything is test this to make sure it works. So with new business, I would say go for the business cards. Get them in, like, business cards from, I don't know, what is the absolute cheapest price that you can do? What's the minimum order for business cards?
100
business cards. How much does that cost for 100? Like, at cost, like, you're not making any profit.
£18 plus
VAT. All right. Let's just say, for argument's sake, £20, right? For 100 cards. So you could actually go in and say business cards from £20. Because that is going to entice people to look. Because people, a lot of people will want business cards and they want them quite cheap. And they'll be like, oh, £20 for 100 business cards. You know, that could be enough for them to do a test run. That's enough for them to look further. And then what you do is you say, look, here you go. Very, very simple. Either upload your design or we'll do your design for you. These are the options that we've got. These are your business cards. Oh, and by the way, you can either have 100 for £20 or if you want to pay 60, we'll do you 1,000. And if you want a different run, then select from the options. But you don't give them all the options. You only give them the two. The 100 and the 1,000. And then there's a little thing. If they want to select more, they can. And then what you want to do is, like, you want to start, like, considering, like, what Ryanair does and what Amazon does. And I talked about this yesterday with upsells. And you say, okay, so do you want to... And the way that you should do this, really, is I would recommend in a way that doesn't piss off your customers. So at that point, once they've put in that order, you say, would you like to check out now? Or would you like to consider adding flyers? Or would you like to look at other promotional equipment, you know, material? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And then you can say, look, because you're ordering the business cards, if you order some flyers, we'll do you a one-time offer, special price of this. And it's like an upsell, do you see what I mean? You're actually, you're getting two orders instead of one. But you're not doing any additional marketing, you're not doing any extra additional work. They're already there. They already want the business cards. You're just giving them the opportunity to get something more. So then what I would do is consider at that point, do they want stationery? You know, what are the things that they might want? And you, this is something for you to go away and think about. You know, you don't have to offer them everything. Just offer them enough. And then what I would do is obviously you send them to their order page where it's like, thank you, your order's been placed. And then go into a system where you tag them and say, this person's ordered business cards. They're interested in this. They've looked at that. And in your CRM system, your contact relationship management system, which you can use MailChimp or ActiveCampaign, there's loads of systems out there. You build up a relationship with this person. You start to create notes on every single time they call, they visit, they place an order, they're interested in, they visit the website. You build up a history of this person. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And then you find out information and you start to fill in the blanks. Like, when is their birthday? Like, when have they got an event? Because if they turn around to you and say, I'm doing an event and I need some flyers for my event. And so you're like, okay, no worries, we can do that. You place the order. What happens? What do you do after they've placed that order? Like, what's your process right now?
At the minute, I don't follow anything up. I don't call them or nothing. We just make a hard copy file and keep it in there. We don't chase anything up.
Interesting. So, okay, and there's nothing wrong with that, by the way, because I think a lot of businesses do that, especially local businesses who haven't embraced technology in its, like, in what's available to it. But that's, there's nothing wrong with that. But consider if you had an online system, and you can start with an Excel sheet. I mean, you've already got a system, but you could start with a really simple system. There are systems out there that, like, $10 a month. They're not expensive. And the idea behind it is...
Yeah.
You could create an automated sequence that says, person has purchased flyers for an event. And then you could actually write an email one time, upload it into this system and be like, hey, I hope your event went really well. I'd love to know how it went. Did you have any pictures of it? Let us know. How were the flyers? Do you see what I mean? Like, it could be an automated follow-up a week after their event. Like, something, like you're saying that what you want to do is build a relationship. If you had something like this in place, that would not only allow you to build a relationship, but it also doesn't involve you because it's automated. Like, you create it once and leave it. So that you, because every time you're involved in the process, you're a linchpin. You kind of, it's a bottleneck. So you can drive so much traffic to your business, but as long as you're involved in the process, it can't go any further until you've dealt with it. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
So the idea is that if we can take you out of this process, if we can just remove you from this process and just put an automated system in there, you actually have the ability then to attract more business. And then they can connect with you later down the line. Because when you consider something like Vistaprint, you can go online, place your order, it is automatically sent to the printing shop. When it's there, it's done. Everything's done automatically. It's printed, it's cut, it's delivered. They have like one or two people in a warehouse checking the machinery. It is completely automated. Amazon's the same. If you've seen the delivery service for Amazon, when you place an order, everything's in warehouses. They've got these little drones that go around the warehouse floor and pick what you've ordered and package it up for you. That's why when you buy a pen from Amazon, it's wrapped up in 6 foot's worth of cardboard. Because the whole process is automated, right?
Yeah.
So someone's saying, Steve, what system should we use for the customer monitoring and notes, the £10 system referred to in your presentation? For $9 a month, you can start with ActiveCampaign. Now, ActiveCampaign may not give you the whole CRM side of it. It will give you the email automation. I think for the whole package, it's about $50 a month. But the bonus is when you're using this in your business, like I really would focus on two things. You've already got customers, right? So, have you got a database? Have you got a list of all your customers?
Not electronically.
Yet.
Not yet, no.
Good answer. So, is there a way that you can put the names and email addresses? Do you have the email addresses of people? Right, so, and this is why, if you have an online shop, it would be really good because you can create an invoice on the website, email it to them, you can do a point of sale, so you can actually have a point of sale display in your shop where they click what they've ordered and they literally check out on an iPad or on a laptop or they do it there and then, or you can ring it in yourself, and that way you're starting, and you can do that in WordPress. If you've got WordPress, you have the ability to be able to create that. It's very, very simple. WooCommerce is a free e-commerce platform, so you could actually put all of your products into WooCommerce, and then when people check out, you've got their name and email address, they're already there. I would suggest, this is my recommendation for you right now, two things. One thing to do is to look at new business and how you can create a simple strategy to attract new people. And I would do that using one thing right now. I'm not saying only do one thing. I'm just saying that right now, just do one thing. And if you focus on the business cards from £20 for 100 and all your promotional material and everything you do is around business cards and getting people involved and to understand you and to know, like and trust you. And that is your IPO. That is your initial product offer. It's £20 for 100 business cards. And then you can upsell it. Actually, you can have 1,000 for £60. And maybe if they do it on a certain day, you'll give them free design or something. Or you'll design their cards. I don't know. You can work that out. You know, or, you know, you charge £75 instead of £60 and you throw in the free design. Which you've said your design's like from £15 an hour. So, like, the best thing you can do is to package and to add more. So you get this, but I'm going to also give you this and give you this and give you this. And you stack the value and stack the value and stack the value. And all of a sudden people are like, wow, I'm getting all this. And it's not costing me any extra. That's a great deal. Then people will start raving about you and talking about you. And you'll start to get more traffic. That's one thing. But before you do that, because that's what I would focus on for new business. Before you do that, I would recommend that you get every single customer that you already have and you put them into a database, either MailChimp or if you can, I highly recommend you use ActiveCampaign for your business. I highly recommend that as a 2-week free trial. You can start cheap, but to do that, start putting all the names and email addresses and all the everything you've got, all the contact information, put it online in a database. And then I would reach out to each and every one of those people and I would say, hi, how are you? Haven't spoken to you for a while. I know you ordered some business cards or some flyers. I just wanted to find out how they were. Do you need any more? Can I help you? Do you know anyone? That would be the first conversation I would have.
Yeah.
Because that is going to be the easiest way for you to bring more business in. And then to focus on the business cards and to get people in that way. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And then just to start tagging people. Okay, so they bought business cards. Okay, so they bought flyers. And then on the website, you can have it so that when they log into the website, you tag them. And ActiveCampaign does this automatically. It can register what page they viewed. So you can actually say, hey, I know you were looking at flyers, but you didn't quite check out. You know, because some people will go into the cart. They'll add it all into the cart to price it up, and then they'll go and look somewhere else. And they may go to Vistaprint or Moo, and they, because what most people will do, this is what we had when I had the printing business, is most people will look at your business, they will compare it to other people's businesses, and they'll normally go with whatever's cheaper or whatever they feel's best. Not everyone.
Yeah.
Some people, because this is the other thing you need to do. You need to decide, what are you going to be? Are you going to be economy cheap Vistaprint, or are you going to be high-end luxury? Like, because when you look at business cards, I look at Vistaprint and Moo. That's just my baseline. Like, if you go for a cheap Vistaprint £5 card, like, everyone knows Vistaprint, they're longer than everything else, they're, you know, the quality of them's not that good, and it's a touch point. So when you hand it over, people go, okay, it's a business card, they don't really feel, think anything about it. But when you hand over like a Moo Lux, that's like a 600 GSM, do you know what I mean? It's like, it's got that real quality to it. Like when you get a letter through the post and it's on that really fine fancy paper that aristocrats use, you know, I don't know, it's just like, it's that really fine paper that, you know, it's just total upper class, like to the master of the house or whatever that's written on the top of it. Do you know what I mean? Like, that has a different feel to it compared to something that's written on toilet paper.
Yeah.
So you first need to understand who you're targeting and what market you're going after. But I know, because we've already talked about this, that the broader market and the but you want to do the Vistaprint, better quality with the personal touch, right?
Yeah.
And because you've got the actual shop as well, I think that is going to be your best way to automate your process, to get the people in the database, to reach out to the people you've already worked with. Make sure you've got testimonials from them. Make sure, like, I ordered these business cards from Amy and they were, or from print people, and they were great. And start getting that up on your website and getting people to say, I did this, I love them, they're great. And get the pictures of people with their cards. Like, get real life case studies.
Yeah,
where
you... I did get some videos as well.
Perfect. Then that's the sort of thing that you want, because as people are browsing and they're looking through, like a video, if you've got a video of all these different companies, you could turn that into a showreel. And that could be like a promotional piece that you use. And you could use that in like your Facebook ads and things like that. I wouldn't necessarily put that on the website too much, because people are scrolling and chances are they don't want to look through loads of videos. I mean, you might have the promo video, but overall, people just want to, like, this is a visual thing, right? Any of the printing you're doing, it's visual. So people need to see it. You should have accounts on Instagram. You should have accounts on Pinterest. You should have accounts like, you know, it's like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest. They're your channels. Everything you do, everything that goes out there. And you should be like, one of the biggest things you can do is build up a following. And then anyone that comes to you, you promote the work you've done to your audience. So like, if you've got the local tire company in Birmingham and you've done their business cards and you say, hey, if you need, you turn around to them and say, look, guys, I'm going to promote you to my audience. Can you do me like a 10% discount on your tyres? Give us a coupon code or something. And you turn around and say, hey guys, we've just done this for a tyre company. If you go there now and type in this coupon code, you get 10% off. And you turn around to the tyre company and say, look, if I bring you some business, give me 5%. So they're getting 5%, you're getting 5%. They don't have to market anything. So now you're building up these like relationships with your clients where you're actually bringing them in more money. Do you see what I mean?
Yeah. Like, yeah.
There's a lot of things you can do here, but the starting point has to be, because I know you said before you want a website. The website really isn't that important. The most important thing for you in your business is a CRM system to capture the details so you can get on the phone, so you can email, so you can reach out. The website could be very simplistic. You can offer things and show people what you do. People might want to come and browse and scroll, and we get that. So you do, like, the e-commerce is a good thing for you to have. But also having dedicated pages that are just like, you want to have a landing page that is specifically geared up for people that are looking for business cards. And it doesn't distract them, and it doesn't show them anything else. It just shows them how they can go ahead and purchase a business card from you. So that you can get them, so that you can get them through the door, and you don't distract them with anything else, so they don't end up going anywhere else. No social media, no other products, just business cards, and just have that as an option. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
I realise I've just been going rah to you and sort of going through this for the last half hour, but does that make sense? Like, you've got the Facebook Live, you can watch this back later, and I've doodled all over it with loads of crazy pictures and things that you'll be able to see. But does this make sense?
Yeah.
Guys, on the Facebook Live, what do you think? I'm going to look through the comments. Does this make sense to you guys? Like, for a local business owner, for somebody who is a print shop, and by the way, check it out, Facebook, what's your Facebook page? In fact, when you go onto Facebook, can you post a link, Amy?
Yeah, just one second, I'll post it up.
If you're on the Facebook Live now, yeah, post a link, please, so that people can find out more about you. I would really, really like to know what you do with this, like, what you're going to use, because for you to move forward, I think the best thing that you can do right now, this is what I would love for you to do right now. I would love for you to invest in a CRM system. You've got a 2-week free trial with ActiveCampaign. I would really recommend that you take that 2-week free trial. And in that 2 weeks, input all of the data of all of your clients into there and then reach out and contact them and ask them how they're doing. And build up a database of your business. Is that something that you can do?
It should be, yeah.
And then, would you do me a favour? Before you start this, would you look at the last 4 weeks, what your gross income was into the business in the last 4 weeks? Don't tell me, but would you just get that number? And then, would you do this for me? And then, in 4 weeks' time, would you let me know the difference?
Yeah, well.
Because if you've got something to actually monitor, like last month we did X in sales and then we did this one thing where we put everyone into a CRM, we contacted everyone on our list and we reached out and we asked them these 3 questions. 1, how are they? 2, were they happy with the order? 3, do they need anything? And 4, do they know anyone? Does that make sense? So contact every single person who you've done business with and ask them, let me just move this camera. First thing you're going to ask is, hi, how are you? Just phoning up to see if you are happy with the order, of the business cards that you had. Everything okay? Were they good? Good points, bad points? Great. Do you need any more or is there anything else that you need? Yes, great. What do you need? No, not a problem. Thanks for your time. By the way, do you know anyone else that might need it? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Like, don't worry about everything else that I've just said. Just in terms of setting up that CRM system with ActiveCampaign, importing all of the data across, and then contacting every single person and asking them 4 questions. Is that something you can do?
Yeah.
How long will it take you to do that?
I can start straight away.
Perfect. All right, so it's Friday now. Do you reckon you can have it done over the weekend by Monday?
The weekend's tough because of personal, but I can start Monday when I'm back at work.
Perfect. Do you reckon you could do it by the end of the week, by Friday?
Yeah, I don't see why not.
Awesome. All right then, so I'm going to check in with you again on Friday the 10th. And hopefully you should have all of your contacts in ActiveCampaign.
Yeah.
And ideally you'll have started contacting them.
Yeah, I will, yeah.
And by the way, everyone on Facebook's just heard you say this. Like, there's nothing like accountability, right? So, Kofi's got a question. Kofi just said, how passionate are you about the business you're running at the moment? It's a great question, by the way.
I'm really passionate about it, to be honest. It's everything I've got and everything I've worked for since I started working young at 16 in a grocery shop, and then I earned it this way. So I really want to push it. I've been here 4 years now. And
4 years?
Yeah, the first 2-3 years was hard, and now it's just starting to show some results, but not the results that I'm looking for, that I need to push at the minute.
And those results at the moment are based around the numbers in terms of the money. Is that what I'm right in believing what you said earlier, that you want to bring more sales in?
I pushed it from the minuses now to breaking even and a bit more.
But which is fantastic, by the way.
Now I just want to generate more sales.
Of course. So generate more sales. See, this is the thing, and this is what I talk about with everyone, and I focus so much on online business, but the reality, this works in any business. You need traffic and you need conversions. You need to attract people to you and you need to make turn them into sales. So the best thing that you need to do at the moment is to create a compelling offer for your new business to be able to attract that traffic. And that, and there's no right or wrong answer to that. I'm only saying use the business cards, because if you focus on one thing as a start point, test it till it works, and then move on to the next thing, then you just replicate that entire system for business cards. You literally just replicate it for flyers, and then you replicate it for t-shirts, and then you replicate it for stationery. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
All we're trying to do is build out one sales funnel at the moment that we can just replicate. But the thing that I really want you to focus on at the moment is you that... The thing that you've said is your result is to bring more money into the business. You've broken even, and by the way, that's fantastic. So 4 years with a physical shop in a business, working since you were 16. So you're 20 now, is that right?
I'm 24. I've been working from 16 in a grocery shop.
So you from 16 in a grocery shop, and you got this when you were 20?
Yeah.
So at 22, you were breaking even in your business. I mean, I think that's fantastic, by the way. I think that's amazing. Can I have some likes and hearts on a Facebook Live? Not for me, but for Amy, please. I think she deserves some hearts for what she's done here. Like, that's an entrepreneur, right? Right there. I really do appreciate you for your time, but not also that, but for what you're doing, because you're getting out there and you're making it work and you're doing it for you.
Thank you.
That's why I wanted to jump on this call with you. Because I can see that there are things that you can do. You put this system in place, it's going to make life so much easier. You're going to be able to automate a huge part of that process. As for the website, don't even worry about the website. You do not need an all-singing, all-dancing website. You don't right now. Even if your website only sells business cards, nothing else matters right now. Nothing else matters. Because rather than looking at the whole picture, like, I want to do everything, if we just focus on one area and we target the people, who are the people? Like, you could target startups in Birmingham. You know, you go on to you look at business startups in the UK, and you look at all the businesses that are just getting started up. You go on to meetup.com, you look at all the business, all the startup, the entrepreneurial networking events, all the people who are starting up businesses, and you go there and say, hey, look, I'm doing a special offer on business cards. You get yourself out, you start networking, you start going to events, you start doing things. Sure, guys, if you've got any questions, just shoot the questions. I'll go through these in a sec. But things like that, if you can start doing that and pushing people into this funnel, into this system, and then nurturing them on the back end, you'll find yourself very quickly in a position where you don't need to market. Like, everyone will be doing it for you.
Yeah.
Make sense?
Yeah.
So, one of the questions that Kofi's just asked, and I don't know if you saw it, it's coming across that you're not feeling confident about it, not sure if it's coming across to everyone else. Do you feel confident at the moment? Honest answer.
I've never been on a Facebook Live before.
So you're just nervous, right? I think to be fair, Amy's a bit nervous. I think, to be fair, in Amy's business, I've spoken to her before. She's very confident in what she does. She's very good at what she does. She's done some amazing stuff before. I've seen it. I know she's good. And so I don't think this is really a confidence thing in her business. I think this is definitely... Amy is pushing herself right now to do new things, and she's learning. And I can tell you the whole reason that we're having this conversation is because Amy's struggling with a website. She had a website built, an e-commerce website, that wasn't getting her results. So now she's had it rebuilt, so it's not an e-commerce or e-commerce store. And it's not live at the moment, is it?
No, I've just checked it today, actually, and put it on, but it's just a template. It's not actually been built yet.
So it's not
just
been
a template.
Can I ask, and you don't have to answer this, but can I ask, how long have you been waiting for this site to be live?
Over a month
to get a template live.
Yeah, about a month ago. And it's still not. I've got a template, but it looks like it wasn't alive at all yesterday, and now I've put my web addressing today, and it's all, but everything's in a different language, so I'm guessing that's just a template.
So, after a month, you've got a template of a site in a different language. So, This is like, you are in a situation that so many other people are in, and I see this every single day, and it's why I wanted to do this today. I think it's so important. There are so many people out there that are focused on that question, I need a website. Like, yeah. What you need is a strategy behind the website. Like, the website is literally a vehicle. What you need are the coordinates to put in the sat-nav to get you from A to B. Like, it's the satellite navigation that you need, and that's what we've done today, is look to, okay, how do we get you from A to B? A is where you are, B is obviously more money in the business. The website is just a vehicle to get you there. And the good thing about a vehicle is you can take a plane, a train, a bus, and, you know, there's like lots of different vehicles that you can use to get there. Yeah, a website will help you, but you don't need to invest too much time, energy, effort, money right now in a website. The biggest thing you should be investing in at the moment is the relationship building with your current clients, and the best way you can do that is from a CRM. You could get on the phone and you could close every single existing client you've got with new orders without even having a website.
Yeah, that's true.
Just get on the phone and say, hi, do you need some business cards? Great, how many do you need? I'm doing 1,000 for 60 quid. Brilliant, okay, I'll send you an invoice.
A lot of our walking customers, don't even know we have a website anyway, because they don't tend to go on it.
Exactly.
They literally just have our card and give us a call.
Your website should do three things, in my opinion. Your website should do, number one, your website should allow people that are ready to purchase to click very simply and to be able to get what they want. So if I go online and I'm like, I want business cards, I should be able to easily and effectively go on and do that. Now, your competition for that is Vistaprint and Moo. And they are big companies with big budgets. So they're going to have a really slick process, but you can have a very simple process. That's not your main driver, but that is definitely something that will pick up traffic. The second thing that you can do, or that you should do, is have a more detailed explanation about the options, so that someone that comes to you that's like, I don't kind of know what I need, I'm not sure what I want, I don't, and they're really undecisive, and you can nurture them by educating them on what's possible. Because you've got the knowledge of, like, here's the different types of paper, here's the different types of print. This is all the things that you need to know in a simple step-by-step process so that you can go ahead and order your business cards. And the third thing that your website should do is it should be SEO'd, and it should be geared, and it should be very obvious that anyone who's local in your vicinity can find you. Like, if I'm on a mobile phone and I type in business cards, Birmingham, I want your website to come up first with a map showing me where your shop is so people can come into your shop.
Yeah.
And maybe you do something like next day delivery or next day print. You know, come into the shop today, order before midday, and we'll have 100 business cards ready for you in 20 or next day, or whatever it is that you can do, whatever's right for you. But those are the marketing campaigns that when you put them in place, they're the things that are going to attract new business. They're the things that are going to get you sales. And then the nurturing through the CRM system is what is going to help to boost your sales. Make sense?
Yeah, makes sense.
I'm not going to overwhelm you. I'm going to leave you with that. Amy, thank you so much. I really, really appreciate your time. Has it helped?
Yeah, it really helped. And I'll watch it back and then I'll be able to do the stuff that you've advised me on. And then fill you in next Friday.
Take your time, watch it back. Don't worry about what I've said. I've kind of just given you as much as I can, like for you and for everyone that's watching. But what I really want you to focus on is a CRM, inputting the details and contacting them. And you're going to do that by the 10th. Yeah. Oh, and before you do that, obviously working out how much money you made last month. And then I want to see how much money you make this month. And I want to compare the difference between this. So, because then you can measure, has this effort that I've put in, has it worked?
Yeah.
Because there's no point doing this if it doesn't work, right? If it works, then you can look at what to do next. Make sense?
Yeah, definitely.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Speak to you soon. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Amy at Print People, and her link is down below, and I can't hang up the Skype call. Sorry. I'll speak to you soon, darling. Bye-bye. There we go. So, thank you so much. I hope this has been valuable today. This is kind of different, right? I did say this was either going to be a car crash or it was going to be really good. But I hope you found that valuable. I've not spoken to Amy about her business before. We had a quick, very, very quick chat earlier, and that was everything I've just given her is based on my experience, because I used to have the same business as her. That's why I was quite keen to do this, because when I used to do my t-shirt printing, like, I know what worked and what didn't, and I understand some things. Also, when you look at the business model here, like, Amy's focus right now is on obviously building a website and attracting new business, but she's already got a client base, she's already got a shop. There's no need to go out and attract new business at the moment when she can look at her existing customers and nurture and look after those. That's going to be a way, especially if she has an automated system like the CRM, that's going to really, really help her to build up that picture so that she can start to tag people to say, oh, do you know what, this, and then it's just a deal process. It's following up, it's checking up, it's nurturing. Like, I spend most of my day, in fact, I'm telling you now, I spend all of my day in my CRM system. I have notes on all of my clients that I'm working with. When did they visit the website? When did I last speak to them? What did they do? What action steps do they need to take? Have they done it? When did I need to do it by? Like, what was it? What are their results? What's their outcome? What was it then? What is it now? Like, all of that information is stored on a contact file, on a contact record that I have. So I can, like, when I speak to that person, I can log in and look at it and I can say, right, here's that relationship. Because I can't remember everything. I can't. I struggle with my own business. So it's important to be able to build that up. You know, I have an Evernote document. Every single client I have, there is an Evernote document for that client. Anytime we talk to them and type up notes, it goes in Evernote. Whenever we map stuff up and we draw out mind maps or wireframes, or we start doing stuff like site maps or flow charts or customer journeys, it goes in Lucid charts. So I've got the accounts. All of my project management all goes through Asana. Everything in Asana, what I need to do, when I need to do it, it's all there. Everything's linked together. So it's like I have these systems in place so that I don't have to worry. I can sit back and literally on my phone, I can just scroll through all of the apps on my phone and I've got access to all of the information I need. So if, for example, Rhett was to phone me up and Rhett was to say, hello, mate, you know, and I can say, hey, I haven't spoken to you since last Thursday when you said you were going to update your about page. Have you done it yet? I can tell all of that on my phone whilst I'm on the call. That's the power of having a CRM system. So you can nurture and you can look after. It's not about automating the system so you're not in place. It's about automating the system so that you have the time to step out and focus on the nurturing. So that's what you'll need to look at doing. I'm going to look through these questions. If you've got any questions, let me know. I'm just reading through. I'm sorry we couldn't get clear a sound. I hope that helped. I don't know. If you like this, please let me know if you liked it. Did you think this was good today? Like, you can give me thumbs up and likes, or you can type in the comments, but just, if you type in the comments, just let me know if you thought this was good or not. Just say, yes, I liked it, or no, and then I'll go back to the other style. I mean, I might do this once a week, once a month, I don't know. If you like it, maybe we can do, like, the beginning of the month, we can do one of these, like a case study on a business. Maybe I'll structure it better, and we'll actually do it, you know, with a bit more planning. This was literally just it was a great idea this morning. I thought, you know what, let's go with it and see what happens. My wife takes care of the finances. I didn't know my numbers. This is a problem I have. Like, all right, I'm gonna share something with you now. Is that Jamie took care of the finances in our relationship as well, and I didn't know the numbers. And because I didn't have money coming in for a long time, I didn't want to know the numbers. But the reality is, you need to know your numbers. Like, it's not your wife's responsibility to take care of all the finances. Like, all right, if she's going to do that, that's fine. But it should be a team thing. Like, you should work together at it. Like, you should at least have an understanding so that if, like, God forbid something happened, you can still take care of everything. It's just good to know. Like, you don't have to be good with numbers. If she's got a strong asset and you've got a strong asset, then you play to your assets. But it would definitely be worth sitting down and just saying, hi, hon, I know you're doing the finances. Can I just sit down with you and just look through it? I don't understand it, but I'm just curious. I'd like to. It's a good bonding exercise, but also the more you work at it, the easier it will become. Like, the maths doesn't have to be complicated. It can be really, really simple. Like, we know what the wages are, we know what the business is, we know the numbers, and then we just work it out. It's a process. So that's my advice anyway, based on my experience. And definitely what I'm working at. Matt Tucker, sorry I'm late. There's no excuse. You're fine. £10. Please send it to my PayPal immediately. People buy because of the why. Yeah, absolutely. Normally it's for them. It's what they want. Amy Phillips. So Amy Phillips has joined. She's on here. So check her out. Hook up with her. Look at what she's got. Just like why people return each morning to a coffee shop. Exactly right. Why do you think that Pepsi or McDonald's focus on kids so much? It's because they understand the fundamental psychology that brand allegiance, you know, that the conviction to a brand at an early age. Like, most people that drink Pepsi won't drink Coke. Most people that eat McDonald's won't eat KFC. Most people that ski won't snowboard. Like, people get a preference of what they prefer, and it's very difficult for them to, well, not difficult, but they just don't want to change. And so big brands, they know that the earlier they can get on board to actually convince you to use their products and services, the more likely you are to become a lifetime customer. Same with your local coffee shop. Now, a lot of times it may just be convenience, because here's the thing. There's a lot of people out there who goes and does the same thing, even though they know it's shit and there's something better out there, but you do it because it's just convenient, or you're just used to it, or it's just the way. So it doesn't, you don't even have to have the best product. You just need to be in front of the person when they need it. If you're in front of the person when they need it, chances are if you're there and you make it so easy for them, then they'll buy it. And if you make it so easy for them, like greed and sloth. If I can address money and I can address laziness, so if I can tell you how to make a lot of money without a lot of effort, you're hooked. The other way, if I can teach you how to save money and it doesn't take a lot of effort, people are happy. Greed and sloth, those two things, if you can tap into those in any of the marketing you do, then you're onto a winner. There's greed, there's sloth, and there's scarcity. So if I can tell you, look, I'm going to teach you how to make a lot of money. You don't need to do anything at all, but I'm only going to allow one person to do it. That's marketing. Love it or hate it, it's marketing. You know, you just have to accept it and understand it, because that's human psychology. It's how it works. It's, you know, yeah, okay, so the things I do are ethical. I don't like to be a douchebag when I market, but at the same time, I respect and understand how the world works and how people make money. Customization is something that is important, and people will pay for that. This is something I can do that very few people can do. Great takeaway. Rhett, that's amazing. Thank you so much for sharing that. I really appreciate that, man. And it's true. Customization. Like, automate as much as you can and then charge for the bespoke. Charge for the implementation. Charge for the customization. Charge for your individual skill sets. Give people what they need so they can take it away. Why do you think I've got my book? People can go and buy my book. They don't have to talk to me. For some people, that's a godsend, right? People can buy my book. It's automated. But if they want me to work one-on-one with them in their business, they're going to pay for it. That's the ascending transaction model. Right, I'm glad you had that takeaway, man. That's fantastic. What system was used? Active Campaign. We mentioned that one. Simon Hinton. Hello, Dylan. How you doing? You give me a great idea for Facebook marketing. Me likey. Share that. Well, maybe you don't want to share that because you've got some competitors in here, right? You and your English competitor guys. But I'm really grateful that you've got a great idea for Facebook marketing, and I'd love it if you could share that. In fact, when you do it, just tag me in it and let me know, because that'd be great. Awesome, guys. So you can use strict.com as an extension in Gmail, Fab CRM. You can create pipeline, track emails, make notes. It's got free option. Awesome. Here's the thing. There are so many options out there. I don't know Streak, but it has made me hungry because now I want a steak for some reason. I would say that, yes, there are so many different options out there. There's no right or wrong option. You need to do what works for you. I've tested so many, and I would say that the thing that I love about Active Campaign, and the reason I'm using it in my business, is one, because it's very visual, it's very easy to use, integrates with everything, and it just, overall, it's got everything that you need. I don't know what Streak's got. It might be worth checking it out. The only thing I would say is to be careful that you don't get caught up, because you could say, oh, look, there's ClickFunnels and Lead Pages and Kajabi and WordPress and Optimized Press, and there's this and that and this, and you could end up going around in circles looking at all the options. Sometimes you just need to get out there. Get something, get it out there, test it, get it working, and then you can look and see what else is out there afterwards. Like, there are times when it's better to plan, and there's times when it's better to implement. Right now, I think with where Amy is and what she's got and what she needs, I don't know Streak, maybe that's a good option, but there's so many options. There's Capsule CRM, there's Sugar CRM, there's Salesforce, there's Infusionsoft, there's Entreport, there's Agile, there's ConvertKit, there's like so many options. But the idea is that sometimes you do need to just pick one and say, do you know what, I'm going with that. And you just need to make a decision and just move with it. Because there is always going to be good and bad in every situation. Always going to be good and bad. What something can do well, it will struggle with something in another area, and what it struggles in one area, it will do really well in another. See, sometimes you just need to make that decision and just go for it. So I'd still suggest at the moment, not knowing Streak, I would suggest at the moment to use ActiveCampaign, just because it is the market leader right now in terms of what's out there, and it's cost effective. But I will definitely look into Streak and see what it's like. I definitely think you're onto a winner if you offer free design of all your cards. That's what I choose from eBay, offering all the suppliers, offering small prices. See, so it's how you stand out. Sammy, that's a great point that you've made there. How do you differentiate yourself from the marketplace? Like, you need to look at your competition. What are they doing? What can I do differently? Okay, so they're all charging for delivery. I can offer free delivery. All right, so they're all doing an automated service. I can do a bespoke service. And it's not like, if it's not broke, don't fix it. I'm not trying to say that, but you need to stand out. If everybody in your industry has a blue logo, then you should have a red one. You know, just do whatever you need to do to stand out, to be different, so that you can actually attract people, and people start looking at you and say, oh, you're different, why? I think a lot of the business will be picked up when you go to the networking events, when you go into local communities, trade shows, anything like that, where people need. Like, you go into MMI, you go to UPW, you go to any of these events where you've got 5 or 10,000 people all looking to start up a new business and become entrepreneurs at the end of it. And you're there with your flyers, handing them out, saying 50% off your business cards, 50% off your business cards. Oh, and we'll do you a free design and you can have them tomorrow. There's your list. Done. Then you just focus on just serving those clients. And then what happens is you pick up, out of the 10,000 people at the event, you pick up 100 people, right? And out of those 100 people, they all tell one person each. And then they all tell one person. And you see what I mean? It's like a snowball effect. I hope that's helped, guys. Right, I've got another idea. I could JV with someone like Amy. Just for look for new business ideas if she's in a position where she could offer JV. See, that's another fantastic idea. Like, I would offer with somebody who works with startups. Like, there could be someone who coaches startups. Look out, like, for example, I don't know if he does it anymore, but Elliot Kay used to do it. Elliot Kay used to work with startups. I know that Derry, Applewood and Davison, I know that his business partner, Dominic, was working, Beecham, if you, I'll tag him on Facebook. But if you reach out to people like this, because they're involved, like Prince's Trust, right? Look at the Prince's Trust. Maybe there's ways there that you can like reach out and JV and work with people who are working with startups and say, do you know what? I've got this service that I can offer startups. That's just another idea. Go to like Google Campus. Go to all of the incubators. Go to all of the launch pads in and around London. Shoreditch. Get all your flyers in and around Shoreditch area, especially in London, because like that's a massive area for startups and entrepreneurs and tech hubs and things like that. There's so many different things you can do. Like right now, it's all about focusing on one thing. Like new business, repeat business. So we're looking at the moment, repeat business, CRM system, get this in place. Get the website up, link it together, then look at a model for new business. And then just use one model to attract people in. Like, we need to start, otherwise it's too much. Like, if I just jumped on a Facebook Live and said, hi, so here you go, use it. It means nothing. You have to go through the process to understand it. So, yeah, I totally get it. It makes total sense to JV if you have the opportunity to. How do you download your videos from Facebook to upload them to YouTube afterwards? I can tell you that. In fact, I've got a course on it. It's $9.99. I'll send you the link. No, I'm only joking. It's a one-time offer, right? What you do is you go onto the Facebook Live itself. There's three little dots in the top corner. You need to be on the actual Live itself. When you click on that, it will say download video, and then I just upload it. And that's the way I do it. I think it's easier to find customers who want unique and individual business cards. They want to pay more for unique product. I did look for these cards some time ago, and there isn't much of a market for them. Well, absolutely, and this is where it comes back to. You need to know your target market. You need to understand who you're marketing to and who you're going to be selling to. Because if you want to go high-end luxury, great. If you want to go cheap budget, great. Understand the cost involved. Understand the market you're going to attract. Understand the competition in that marketplace. And then decide from there. Like, we used to go really budget cheap because our business cards were a loss leader. They offered us into t-shirt printing and they offered us into other things. We used to make like a few hundred pounds on garments. And so spending £5-10 on business cards was like a no-brainer for us, because the back end of it, we would end up with more orders. So yeah, I mean, you know, you may even want to do a promotion. Like, you could do a promotional idea where you actually give away 1,000 business cards and everyone has to do something, and whatever it is they have to do, you know, they get that thing. You can also look at, there's loads of things you could do. You could do something really fun in Birmingham. Like, you could do like an Easter egg hunt. You know, we're coming up to Easter now. You could do an Easter egg hunt with flyers, and people can find coupons around this Easter egg trail, and you could actually do eggs. And around the eggs, you could have the flyers, and you could be like, hey, if you like this, then contact us. And you could actually like sponsor an Easter egg hunt, do all the flyers and promotions for all the Easter egg hunts in Birmingham and make sure that your promotion material is on all of it, promoting yourself. Like, there's a huge way to gather more traffic. There's so many things you can do. When you're not focused in the day-to-day running of your business and you step back and like, oh, look, here's some ideas and things I can do. Like, you can just sit down and spend a day literally just hacking out ideas and then saying, that's good, that's bad, that's good. And you have, at the end of it, the table, here's a selection what we're going to run with. And you take one and you implement it and you test it. Minimum viable product, get it working, test the results, what's the outcome, where are we now, where do we want to be, is there a result, is it worth it, great, let's carry on with that. No, let's try something else. That's business, right? Very insightful. Steve Bentley, thank you very much, really, really appreciate it. Was good, enjoyed it, just joined at the end, but it was good, all right, well, appreciate that, thank you very, very much. That's going to cover Ben's fine. Everyone can take something away from today's live. I've got something too. The way your Facebook live shows, we all have similar problems in the business and what we can do with them. Really, really good. Right. This league's, I love the banter with you guys. Right. Well, look, thank you so, so much. I really appreciate you guys. I'm going to end this now. I will be back on Monday. So have an amazing weekend. I'm going to be at an event tomorrow. I'll see about live streaming it if I can. I'm not sure what's happening. I'm going to be there all day. And then I'm also at another event on Sunday. I'm going to be checking out some competition and seeing what they're doing because I've got a big event in London. Have an amazing weekend. I will be back on Monday and we will be talking about sitemaps and wireframes and we will talk about the structure of a website and all the things you need to do and then how we can lay out the pages and things like that. So I hope this has been useful. I hope you've enjoyed it. Don't forget to check out Amy. Have an amazing weekend. Don't forget to tag anyone that you feel should like would value from this. Please tag them below if they need to know about it. Share it. I'd be very, very grateful. Like, subscribe, do whatever you need to do. Just send me some money through PayPal. Money joking, you don't need to do that. Chocolate's much more preferred. Have an amazing weekend. I love you guys. Thank you so much for all your support. Mwah. Take care. Goodbye.